it's genetic level. Does it influence our genes expression? And this is experiment on genes expression. And we gave them pain formula to experiment with. And receptor with which is responsible for pain signals was suppressed the most, which means that energy influences gene expression. And we had a lot of other experiments, unfortunately I don't have time for that, changing different genes expression. And what was interesting, that we took some substance and infused a non-infused substance. And first, gene regulation was significantly enhanced with the addition of subtle energy pattern, its anti-aging pattern. And what is interesting also, that it regulated genes where this substance didn't regulate without being infused. Now, it's what important, can subtle energy help us to fight with environmental pollution? Of course, we know perfectly how polluted our environment is. But it is polluted not only chemically, it's also polluted energetically. One of the reasons, presence of electromagnetic field now, all our devices, cell phones, routers, televisors, computers, and so on. So, but Professor Joy Jones, whom I already mentioned, did experiments with cells damaged by gamma radiation. And he observed, first he did experiments with prionic healers, and then he used our energy to support cells and found that in certain conditions, cells damaged by gamma radiation can be restored with the help of energy. But this restoration was quite different in energetically clean environment and energetically polluted environment. He asked these prionic healers to clean environment in his lab, and he had in conditioned lab, he called it, like with prionic healers, 88% success with restoration of cells damaged by gamma radiation. Our energy patterns, when we first came to him and started these experiments, we thought, oh my goodness, we have so powerful energy, more powerful than any healer, we will overcome this just with amount of energy. No way. We had 89% success in healing in conditioned lab. In non-conditioned lab, the same approximately like pranic healers, and zero effect in energy dirty labs where they dissected animals and energy definitely was not clean. So then we realized that it's not just amount of energy, but informational properties of these energies, how they program our cells is important. So we created protection energy pattern and infused in the same liquid where these damaged cells were grown. And immediately from zero success, an experiment that has 78% success, which means that cleaning environment tremendously helps healing process. Of course, in any modality. Now, then we decided to see if we can not just infuse into substance where cells are growing or functioning, but just cleaning environment. And we created this energy which we call clean sweep. It's right here on the table. And we used it in a dirty lab. And we said this result. In a non-conditioned lab, from 10% it jumped to 87%, and from dirty lab, from 0%, it jumped to 68% success. Again, it's just confirmation how subtle energy can be helpful for cleaning environmental conditions. And he observed how external pollution influences. He sprayed it and observed in dirty lab, for instance, with time, how this success of experiments drops. And it dropped in about 6 days, practically, for zero effect. So it means that pollution coming continuously, and you need to clean continuously your environment if you want to have clean conditions. That's, I finished that. And now Dr. Игорь will tell you about, yeah, it's sprayed, it's just sprayed. But it can be also played like we played. Now, I wanted to tell you just the force will be with you always. Dr. Eger will tell you about another our experiments with Schumann resonance. It's another example, I would say opposite example. How using positive environmental energies we can create energy patterns which we can use in our daily life.
Okay, is it Haddon here or is it just me? So we're going to have some fun now. Because we're talking about Schumann resonance. Because in Ashland, in New Age community, everyone talking about Schumann resonance and how it's important, and people just using all these frequencies different way. And I guess nobody knows what's actually going on with Schumann resonance. And I guess that the plasma generator, which Dr. Yuri Kron was talking about, was created before him. It was created by God when he created this planet. And Schumann resonance actually a part of it. So how come? Very simple. So we have a huge layer of atmosphere above our heads, right? And so we just like 100 kilometers, 200 kilometers, 300 kilometers. Like from here to Reading, we have the whole atmosphere. If we go up, presented like air we are breathing in. So what is it? It's oxygen and nitrogen. 80% of nitrogen, 20% of oxygen, just a small amount of other gases. Then we have ionosphere, as you know. What's ionosphere? The same atmosphere, but very thin amount of particles lower by the cosmic rays, all these beings going to the Earth from everywhere, ionize these gases, and they start activating. And so a concentration of electrons going high, like 10 to the power of 5, 6, 7, that is plasma. You see, we have a plasma generator above our heads, which working day and night with different activity during the day and during the night. And now the question, what's Schumann resonance? But we have a lot of lightning going on the Earth, right? Like about 100 per second, lightning is striking somewhere on the Earth. And what is lightning? It's an electrical charge. What is electrical charge? It's a huge current going from the cloud to the Earth, creating radio waves, and they are going around the Earth. And now we need to go back to scale, right? So we talked about it. Very thick layer of atmosphere, ionosphere. So how thick is it to compare with the diameter of the Earth? If this is the diameter of the Earth, the atmosphere is the thickness of my hair. You see how narrow is this gap for the whole Earth? And what's happening when all this radio wave going through this gap, some of the smart wave goes directly around the globe, creating so-called standing wave. This is base frequency of the Schumann resonance. If you divide circumference of the Earth by the speed of light, you will get exactly 7.5 Hertz. That's a basic frequency of Schumann resonance. And as Yuri told you before, every frequency has harmonics and subharmonics. And so then we have 11 1912 and other frequencies of the Schumann resonance, how they observe in different laboratories. But the digits not that round as I discussed, because we have different physical phenomena like the electricity of the atmosphere, different local condition, and you know that equator and the polar circumference of the Earth is different, which causes different frequencies of this resonance, which are measured in the experiment. And I just was talking the last week to one of the scientists in Tomsk University in Siberia. They do monitoring on an hourly basis. That's how Schumann frequencies look. And they analyze this data. And he told me that they vary this data, not during day and night, because our layer of ionosphere is different, but also depending on the different place on the Earth. But basically, plus, minus 10, 15%, they are the same. And we're going back to the generator Dr. Yuri Kron was talking about. This plasma is vibrating with these frequencies, which you saw before, day and night. And what this ionosphere actually gives us subtle energy flow, which going on the surface of Earth and on everyone on us. And it was noticed right after Otto Schumann discovered these frequencies in 1954, that brain waves, alpha, beta, delta, gamma, and so on, strangely enough, they correspond to these Schumann resonance frequencies. And which came to a conclusion, it's just an assumption. Maybe it was the first subtle energy generator created by God to develop our human brain. Because you see this theta rhythm, which goes to alpha rhythm, 7.8 hertz, that's the base frequency of Schumann resonance. If we look at the brain activity, it goes from the dreaming state. You remember about Australian aborigines, right? They're dreaming. They're communicating with the universe, dreaming. There is a word over there. But it's not conscious wave to understand about our universe. And then we go from alpha to beta. You see, like four Schumann frequencies, they correspond to four different regions of the beta rhythm of our brain. That, like Schumann frequencies, they're training our brain to be in synchronicity, in harmony with the Earth. So I guess God didn't take a patent for this generator, and Yuri Kron has all rights for that now. But how we can use it? And we have good friends of ours who created hypersensitivity to electromagnetic field. You know, many doctors admit now that there is a real problem, hypersensitivity to electromagnetic field, and some people, our good friend of ours presenting here, wasn't able to use even cell phone because of the problem with his head. But what if we infuse, using our technology, this Schumann resonance frequency into this sticker we place on the phone? How it will work? And then science helps us to determine how it works. Because sensitive people we are working with, they're telling you immediately, I can do muscle testing on every one of you using cell phone with a sticker, without the sticker, that you have a noticeable difference, so you will feel much better out of interest. But there is an EEG technique, electrodes on your brains, and they analyze electrical activity of your brains with the phone, without the phone, with the phone, with a sticker. And that's how this brain activity looks in a normal state. Basically, green is good, to make it shorter. But when you place a phone on your head, you see the brain is getting red. Red is hyperactivity. Hyperactivity is not good, as you know, with the kids when you're trying to take care of 5-7 of them, so it's better when they are quiet. The same with the brain. If we're in normal, balanced state, so our brain is great. If we play sticker on that, so you see this frontal lobe zone, it goes to normal green state. It's only pilot research which was done on 10 subjects, people. A lot more research supposed to be done, but you know the situation with all the cell phone industries, and you know that we have now more cell phones in the world than people in the world. And in some countries, like in little Panama, we have 3 cell phones per person. And which is much more dangerous. Kids are using cell phones with their cranial bones very thin, with their size of the head very small and not formed. Ultimately, their neurological profiles is much more dangerous for them. And that's how we present these stickers on our website. And there are curious minds that just decided to check if it works good on people, how it works on the plants. And Ken Brown just placed 2-1 without any sticker in the water, and this guy was a sticker. The sticker was different for another way how we create them. It could be round, it could be rectangular, but you see with your own eye that it's like 2-3 times bigger than that. Some people were placing it with papayas, and they claimed that papayas growing bigger like 2-3 times. I don't know. I didn't check it, but we just accepted this picture, and we are very grateful for that. That's a testimonial which done exactly from Ken Brown, who was unfortunate to create this hypersensitivity to the electromagnetic field, but which makes him a very good friend of ours, because we are ready to present him our new products to check on him how it works. Okay, next slide please. And now we're coming to Galina, because she is going to tell you about endocannabinoid system which we have in our body. And that marijuana is a very good friend of ours, because the plant in we have the same system of receptors, and how we are able to use it using our technology.
The last our part, we will explain product what we developed. We have thousands of patents, but we bring some of them only, and we should kind of left 1 hour for this. It means that if you would like, we have another break, 10 minutes, and after that we will talk about our product and our practical application. Okay. I guess
no break is better, right? Because it's difficult than to...
Okay.
That's the point of
the